Hey y'all, it's your girl Polish CEO and I am back with another video. So today I am going to show you guys how I plucked my 360 lace wig and I did baby hairs. Now y'all know I don't do baby hairs. This is my very first time installing this, and I'm actually using the boho active glue. So this is a 360 lace wig that I have worn before. That's why the lace is cut off of it. I love this wig. This is my go-to wig. I'm just pretty much brushing it out. I haven't washed it or anything because it's been on the mannequin head. So I'm just pretty much just brushing it back so you can see how the edges currently look on it. So like I said, y'all, this is my very first time attempting to pluck the entire hairline and cut baby hairs and everything. So I know that most people have a specific method to plucking. So right now I'm just actually parting off the first section that I'm going to pluck, and I am securing the rest of it back with the clamp. The tweezers that I have comes in a set, and I actually ordered them from Amazon. I will link those down in the description. And out of that set, I'm going to use the flat angled tweezers, and you want to use the angle part and not the the pointy part when you begin to pluck. Like I said, I know people have specific methods that they use, and I didn't use any kind of method. I pretty much just went in and started along the ear, and then I kept parting and combing to get the desired look. It's kind of a difficult thing when the wig doesn't have the lace on the front anymore. So I didn't want to put like a pin in the lace because this is not that type of mannequin head, and also I do not want to damage the lace in the front where my baby hairs would be. So like I said, I'm just kind of going in and parting off a section and then plucking, and then I'm going back farther and parting off another section and then beginning to pluck. And I comb in between plucking sections so that you can remove all of that excess hair. So y'all, the look I'm going for today is I want to do like a half up, half down, because I have never done that with a wig before. So I was like, I'm plucking, I might as well go ahead and do like a ponytail and, you know, do the half up, half down thing. So that's why I'm kind of going back a little far, because the hair, the top part will be in a ponytail. So I kind of wanted to pluck back a little farther. So I'm going to continue to pluck my lace all the way to the other side. From ear to ear is what you want to pluck, is what I'm going to pluck today. So I've already installed my wig cap, and I am using the Bold Hold Active Glue. I will link that down in the description below. This is my very first time using this too. I normally use like the Got to Be and then the Got to Be Gel, but I hear good things about Boho. So I was like, you know what? Your girl is going to try that, especially for the half down, half up look. How I'm applying it is I'm putting it from ear to ear, and then I'm just taking my comb and I'm brushing the excess backwards. Now with this glue, You do not have to blow dry it because it will actually turn clear on its own. Once it is clear, you will know that it is ready or dry. But I'm going to go in and put a second layer because I do want to kind of keep this wig on for a couple of days. So I'm just going in and I'm putting a second layer of glue. And like I said, you do not have to use the dryer. It will actually dry by itself. And you will know that it's dry because, like I said, it will turn clear. So now that my two layers of glue are pretty much dry, I'm going to go ahead and pop on my wig. Okay, so now I'm just securing the back. Of course, you know that it has combs in the back. And with this part, you definitely want to be very, very careful, especially if you do not have the excess lace in the front of your wig to pull and tug and place it where you want. So that is kind of a task to do. You just have to really pay attention because, like right there, I kind of almost had some more hair stuck in my glue, y'all. But it didn't get stuck, which I'm glad about that. But once you stick this wig down, honey, with this bow hole, it is stuck. Y'all see my side over there. Do you hear me? It is stuck. Now I'm just going in with my comb and I'm pretty much just mixing it in. Or look at my side, y'all. That wig is stuck, baby. I'm going back in with my bow hole and I'm just applying more glue to the places that are lifting or that did not stick. And I'm doing that with the end of my comb, of course, you can tell. And now I'm going in to part off or section off my baby hairs. Now, I did keep the side part in this wig just so that I can see how to place it. But I am not, like I said, I'm wearing a half up, half down. I'm not going to do a side part. But I did go in and pluck some more because I felt like I wanted the front to be a little more out, a little more scalpish. You know what I mean? So I'm just parting off my baby hairs that I'm going to pluck as well. And then I'm plucking more of the hairline. So I'm using my comb to comb out the excess hair from the plucking. And y'all, do you see that part? Okay. It will not go anywhere. It's like the side part was here to stay, baby. And I think it was because, like I said, I didn't wash the wig. And when I did wear a side part, I put concealer in my part. So, of course, it can look more natural. So, instead of doing a side part or a half up, half down, I decided to just go with the middle part and just keep it at that. So, right now, what I'm trying to do is part my middle part and, like I said, keep my baby hair section off. So I did go back in with my tweezers and pluck my middle part. I had worn a middle part on this wig before, but I guess it was in a different spot. So I'm just plucking again to make this look more natural. Now I'm going to go in with my heat comb and flatten out my middle part sides. So now I am taking some foam and I'm putting them on my baby hairs. And I'm also going to put them on my sides to kind of slick them down even more. So after putting on the foam, I'm going to go ahead and take a headscarf and just tie it down. Once my scarf is secure, I'm going to take my blow dryer and blow dry it dry. And once I remove it, baby, look, my baby hairs and my part and everything is kind of molded. So I'm just going to kind of blow dry it to dry it some more to make sure it's completely dry. And then I'm going to go in with my, this is actually a brow razor. And I'm just shortening up my baby hairs. Like I said, y'all already know I'm not a baby hair guru, but I kind of doing a little song, so I'm just kind of cutting them off short. And so they say that the brow razor makes it an uneven cut, which makes it look more natural. So I just added some more foam onto the baby hairs, and then I'm going to take my baby hair brush and go ahead and shape the mugs up. So after shaping my baby hairs, I'm going to take my scarf and tie it down. And y'all, this is the final look. I did my makeup, you know, like a little natural look. And y'all, I really like my hair. Like, it really looks good. This is, like I said, this is my first time. Y'all, let me know down in the comments if you like it.